I strongly feel this formula, if well applied properly, it can solve every human problem. Because basically our problem is in the issue of health. How can we live a better and healthier lives? Secondly, how to properly run business by individual. Create things from the things we have around us. Also, we need technological breakthrough. And technology is going to come from you. I say it's going to come from you. Because what we are studying today is to be applied in a more practical way. And that is simply technological breakthrough. The ability of turning what is existing into a new thing. And we need to master that art. Then we look at the area of agricultural advancement. Today the world is talking of famine. There's no food. People are dying all over the world. But we have the land. We have the resources in the forest, which we can turn into usefulness by us. Then we have the vocational variety. We have today students, graduates, who come from school after graduation. They are unable to know what to do. I was privileged to be asked one day by a director of an organization. After my secondary school, I was looking for employment. He said, son, my friend, what can you do if we employ you in this organization? I was thinking, looking up, there was no answer I could provide. I have to tell you that from what I was able to study in secondary school, I was unable to really say up a point what I can do to contribute to that organization. And that was not fair enough. So we need to think about vocational variety. Have to equip yourself, your hand, your brain, your mind, so that after your secondary school, even after your university education, you can be able to turn things around for the better. Then we need to consider the academic dimension, which is why we are here right now. We are not going to talk details about the health, the happening, the technology and all that, but we are going to focus on the academic dimension. If we must conquer the problem of health, poor healthcare, technology, and the ease of the society today, we know that we have a basic fundamental problem, and that is our academic background. Our academic background is falling. The standard of education is falling every day. The government is talking about it. The society is concerned. But the problem still persists. And they say, evil prosper when good men sit down to do nothing. That is why some of us have taken it as a challenge to come and address you. I know after this lecture, after this moment, after this lecture, listen very well. Your academic life cannot remain the same. But I will come out with distinction in every field of your study in the name of Jesus. Yeah. So, what are we talking about? We are talking about resolving a primary problem, our academic life, which is a major problem. We are talking about how to overcome the problem of examination malpractices. Many students today, they believe and they depend on how to manipulate and pass most of the exam. In Isoko, for instance, in our environment, you see a lot of people during registration for WAEC and SSE, they go to the riverland area. Do you know why? Have you asked yourself why? Should it be so? Do examination malpractice, which is actually not helping the student and it's not helping the society. So we need to look at how do we solve this problem. And that is what basically this lecture is trying to address. Not only that, we need to see how we can produce product from secondary school, our higher institution, with high mental and professional ability. What am I trying to say? We see students and graduates today who comes out of our school, some of them say we read Agric, we read engineering, even computer and whatever. You see their carry paper looking for work in the street. And the government says, there's no work. And most of them still sit down doing nothing. That is not fair enough. That's not helping us. That's why we must come together like this, to a seminar like this that will help us to improve our mental and academic ability. Not only that, I was passing through this Iran only some time ago. And two ladies were walking, and the other one asked her friend, say, how was the exam? The girl responded. He said, my friend, I don't know what to do. I'm tired. It's like I would tell my parents that I would stop schooling. The other one asked her, what is the reason? He said, all the things I have read, studied, during the examination, I could not really remember one. It's like I'm preparing to go into family or to go and marry. A young lady was talking. I really pitied her. And that is one of the reasons. You see that many people, the many youth, out of such frustration, they go into cultism, they go into drug abuse, or today we have the problem of militancy. Many of them are frustrated out of school because they don't have the solution. They take the key that will help them to really master the academic rudiments. And that's one of the things why we are here. So we are here to partner with the government to be able to solve this malady, the academic problem. And by the grace of God, there shall be a solution. I said there shall be a solution. Yeah. And the solution is here. So in this lecture series, we are trying to focus on the code for effective study. The code for effective study. If you must study very well and effectively, study effectively.